Hi guys, I'm Finn, and welcome to the stories of my life. My mom always says that if time passes so quickly, it means you're having a period full of happiness. Yes, I was really happy. I have never felt 3 years of my life would have passed so quickly that in a moment of suddenly slowing down, I realized how much Amsterdam High School had changed me. So, in today's episode, how my high school has changed my life. I know it's pretty late to make this video as I'm in the senior year, ready to be kicked out of school, but my love for Amsterdam is still burning like it was 3 years ago. From an emotionless and unconfident introvert, I have become a more mature person who lives with purpose and interest. When I got into Amsterdam High School in the June of 2018, my whole life just started to change. After spending a year cramming for the fucking high school entrance exam, I'm grateful that I was paid off and succeeded in scoring the highest score in the entrance of our school's geography specialized class. To me and a lot of students in Vietnam, Amsterdam has always been our dream to get into. I was 15 at that time, smack dab in the middle of an awkward adolescent transition phase, and realized that I had to start fighting for myself a personality, a talent, and a hobby, and not being a bookworm who only knows about studying here at UMS. That would be a filler, I thought so. UMS is where I found my true passion. When I got into the school, I got so nervous because surrounding me is a pool of gifted students who not only study well, but also excel at extracurricular activities. Then I realized, oh my god, I had to find something for myself, something unique here. After exploring different kind of arts, ranging from dancing to singing, I have never found something that suits me better than photography. In the summer before my first semester of high school, my cousin gave me a Canon 500D as a gift. Since I'm the only person who understands English in my family, I took it upon myself to read through the instruction manual thoroughly. Later that day, I hurried into the school for a summer event called Panorama, with a new camera to prepare for the summer event. Suddenly, I looked up and noticed the soccer arena, wrapping my camera from my back by instinct, then pulling my friend over to stand with me near the center of the field. I vividly remember looking through the viewfinder, holding tight to the grip, and finally hearing the click of the shutter button in that moment. In fact, I realized that I found the scene much more spotlighting in the camera than it was in reality. All the colors of life integrated so perfectly. The dim blue sky with the white spongy clouds combined with the orange sunlight spreading along the west covered the green grass of the soccer field. Instantly, I started again noticing the smallest, simplest elements of life, the birds, the cracks on the bleachers, the branches of trees, and the sunshine, all of which I had missed for such a long time. I also noticed my friend's laughter, full of happiness. At UMS, I also earned a chance to meet a plethora of amazing and talented people. The students here always consider each other like family in every single project and events they do together. The senior, junior, and freshmen always support each other to achieve the best in their own time. That's why we have the term called Intercore. Not only did I get the chance to improve my photography skill, but also videography. And guess what? Until now, I have produced more than 10 music videos and short films, and became the media directors of two clubs, a path that myself 5 years ago have never expected. UMS is also where I found myself and be myself for most of the time. In secondary school, I was bullied for being bisexual, thrown curse words, and isolated for being what they call different from my peers. Despite intense stress and depression, thankfully I was brave enough to get through the trauma and got out of it. Fortunately, I found acceptance among the people of Amsterdam High School. When I first came out to my classmates, their reaction were the antithesis of the shunning I had experienced before. They said casual things like, "Oh cool man, I have never had a gay friend." used to see them here on the campus. That was also the first time I noticed a lesbian couple holding hands outside my class. The definition of normal and abnormal that has seemed so fundamental began to fade away. It was also a place where I learned a lot of things. My two biggest lessons here is that, first, you have to love yourself. Love what you're doing. Be proud of yourself. And second, your and my opinions matter. I'm proud of my convictions. I will always listen open-heartedly, but no longer shy for confrontation. I have resolved that my work will change minds, rather than bend to the values that others imposed on me like the time I was bullied in secondary school. Honestly, the coin always has its two sides. Because of the freedom that AMS gave, I started to have the audacity to skip class together with my friends, entering the school at 9 a.m, trying to avoid the guards, getting on the fourth floor talking together. But most of all, I got to study what I profoundly love, publicly talking in front of a large crowd, becoming the leader of social projects and clubs, partying, dancing, performing, driving on a motorbike till morning, crying, getting heartbroken to be awakened. I started to live for the small moments. I started to love myself more than ever and get rid of my identity confusion in secondary school. I even started to be a more well-rounded person and no longer shy from humans. So, Hannah Amsterdam, you're just amazing. I know that I'm still falling off the cliff and worry about what I'm gonna do to earn a living, whether I'm going to be a filmmaker or not, what I'm gonna do at the University of Rochester, if I'm gonna love her in the future or not. But no matter what's gonna happen, the years I spent with you are fantastically awesome. Thanks, Ives.
Con cảm ơn cô Trang. Cảm ơn tất cả mọi người vì đã khiến tôi trưởng thành hơn như bây giờ.